Hello everyone and welcome back to this channel. In this video, I'm going to talk about the Program Organization Unit, POU in Codesys. What are they and how to create and use a POU in Codesys? POUs are the software entities that contain the programming codes. Inside these POUs, we write our codes and the codes will be executed by CPU. According to the IEC standards, we have three types of program organization units in Codesys: program, function, and function block. The first POU is program. A program is a POU where the application code is written and supplies one or more values during execution. After execution of the program, all values are retained until the next execution. Your application can be split up across multiple programs, and different function block and functions can be called inside the program to avoid having a large and complicated program. Inside the Codesys, if you look here under the application, you will notice that there is already a program POU called PLCPRG. So until now, we have just used the program to write our codes. If you go to the properties of this program, you will see the object type POU. This is automatically added by Codesys and is called within the main task. This means that it is constantly running and executed by CPU. As I said, until now, we have written all our codes inside this main program. But if we have a large program with lots of codes, it's better to divide our program instead of putting all your codes into one program area. So to add a new POU, simply right click on the application section, add object, and then click add POU. Once you click, this pop-up window will appear. Here you can give the POU name. Then select the type of POU that you want to create: program, function block, or function. For now, I'm going to add a program. We're gonna back to this when I want to create a function and function block. The language that we want to use, we can select at the bottom by clicking the drop down here. Hit add. This will then add a program POU to the PLC logic, which you can see here under the application. I'm going to write a simple code to explain how we can use several programs inside our application. Assume we have a square and we want to calculate the perimeter and area. Let's write the code for the perimeter inside the main program and the area in the second one. I'm going to declare two variables. Perimeter is the length of one side multiplied by 4. Next, the area inside the new program. Like what we do in the main program, PLCPRG, we can declare variables for this particular program. And your codes down here. Area equals a side length squared. Still, I need to do something and my program is not completely defined, but I don't do that to show you what happens. Start the simulation and log in. You will notice the newly created program is grayed out and it has been not executed. If you want to change the value inside the new program, it doesn't actually operate and I can't do anything. Here, what you should notice is that this newly created POU has not been automatically added to the main task of the PLC, so it is not scanned. That's the point that we have to call the program when we have created a new one. You can call programs inside the task configuration or on different programs, functions, or function blocks to create tasks. On the task configuration, in the task configuration, you define one or more tasks for controlling and executing the application program in the controller. Each application must include a task configuration object in Codesys. Click on main and add object, select program call. The program to call is going to be the program that we have created. Hit OK and then add. As you see now, the new POU is added to the main task. Download the program again. As you see now, both programs are working and we can change their values. We can also add a new task if we want. Right now we have just a task that is executing every 20 milliseconds, which is our main task. Let's say we want a new program to be executed every 1000 milliseconds. So we need to create another task. To add a new task, click on Task Configuration, Add Object, and Add a New Task. Write a name. Change the time. Now we have created another task which will be executed every 1000 milliseconds. Basically, it's going to run this task once every second. With the combination of priority and type, you define the order in which the tasks are processed. For example, if you have several tasks with 50 milliseconds, then Codesys processes the tasks with the highest priority first. You can also configure a watchdog for each task. Just to show you how the new task is working, I'm going to use a variable and increment the value by 1 with each cycle. Did the program call from the main task and call it in the new task. Log in again. As you see, the variable is incremented by 1 every second. The third way to execute a POU is to call the POU within another POU that is already being called in the main task. Here we can call it inside the main program PLCPRG. Open PLCPRG and then write the name of the program that we have just added followed by brackets and semicolon. I'm going to delete the POU in the second task. This method is useful if you want to call your program during certain times or conditions inside the main program. Now the value is incremented every 20 milliseconds because the program is called inside the main task with a cycle time of 20 milliseconds. The next POU is function. You can select other types of POU such as function and function block, which can be written to perform a set operation that can be called multiple times in a program. They give us the ability to make our own instructions. For example, if we need to calculate the area of several squares instead of writing this code several times inside a program, we can create a function that calculates this value and then use this function inside the program. Let's create a new POU and a function. A function is designed to receive some input arguments being executed and returning a single value. It can be used many times in your application, but the result is not retained in memory once executed. Here we can determine the type of the function output. Now the new function is created. In the declaration section, we can define input and local variables. In the first line, you see the type of returned value. Input arguments are declared between the keyword var input and end var. I'm going to declare a variable for the side. And here we can declare the local variables. Local variables are visible only inside the function, meaning they will be used just inside the function and other POUs won't have access to them. They are reinitialized at each function invocation. Let's calculate the parameter using the function. The output of this function will be the parameter, so write the name of the function with the assignment and the code for parameter. In our main program, use the variable parameter to save the result of the calculation with this function. Write the name of the function parameter with a bracket. Codesys will automatically show you the inputs of the function to assign them a value. As we have defined, the function has just one input. So this function takes the value of site using this code here, and the function call calculates the parameter and then return the value which will be stored in this variable. Use the function for two more squares to calculate their parameter. I'm going to define an initial value for these variables. Login. Now, instead of writing the codes inside the main program for each squares, we have just used 3 times the function. For now, our code is very simple. If you have to calculate something complicated with lots of codes, functions and function blocks makes the code easier and shorter. The third POU is the function block. The main difference between function and function block is that function does not have persistent data, so it is used to do some tasks and at most return a value or output, and the data will not be stored for the next scan. But function block can save its data and they can be used for the next cycle. For function block, some options are available to extend the function block features that can be used, for example, in object-oriented programming using Codesys. They are for the advanced level and I'm not going to talk about these features in this video. Create a function block. Like function, here you see the declaration part. Inside function block, we can also declare output variables here. This time, let's use our code for the area and write it inside the function block. I'm going to declare variable for site and area. To show that a function block can have multiple outputs, let's declare another variable, for example, for the unit, which is square meter. It will be a string variable. Code for the area. As I said, function block saves the data for the next cycle using an instance. The call of a function block always takes place via this instance of the function block, and Codesys stores the result of a function block's call inside this data block. So inside the main program, we need first to declare an instance for our function block. Write the name with assignment, and then the name of your function block. Then call the instance in the programming environment. Codesys shows you like function the inputs to assign them a value. Because in function block, we can have more than one output, we need to assign them a variable if you need to use them. Write the name of the instance of function block and then a point. Select the output area. Do this for the unit. Now this function block will be executed using this instance and the data will be stored there. With this assignment, we have used the data inside the instance block in our program. Repeat the function block call 2 more times. If a function block is used more than one, the names, allocated memory, and all instances of the function block remain separate from each other. It's exactly like when we want to add a counter or timer. Log in and download the changes. Now we have the area of each square with the unit at the output. If a POU calls a program and the values of the program change as a result, these changes are retained until the next program call. Be careful, programs and function blocks can call a program. But the program call is not permitted in a function because there is no instance of programs. Next point is that like a function from outside of the function block instance, you can access only the input and output variables of a function block, not the internal variables. Access to a function block instance is limited to the POU in which the instance is declared unless you have declared the instance as global. With the ladder logic diagram, everything is the same. Just for calling a POU after you have created your program, function, or function block, a new category POU will appear under ladder elements. With drag and drop, you can call them. When enable is activated, the second program will be executed. Or simply just insert a box and write your POU name. As you see, the function block is called. Input and outputs and instance data is automatically created. Just declare the variables and the new POUs are ready to use. Alright, that was another Codesys tutorial about POUs. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you have any further questions, don't hesitate to ask it in comments. Bye.